run me through the sequence of events that happened to you.
What happened was me and my friend went to the local pub to watch football, and then after the game we decided to get a Chinese, and then the incident happened somewhere in between the pub and the Chinese. They hit me with something, and then they took like the inside of a yellow bin out, and they were hitting that off my head, which I think they broke my nose and my cheekbone and fractured my eyes.
David, I mean, it's quite possible that you were simply unlucky, but on the other hand, it's possible that there were some aspects of your behaviour that evening that meant that it was more likely that you were picked on. And what I'd like to do is to see if we can get into the mind of an attacker and see it from that person's point of view, OK? Yep.
To do that, I brought David to Glasgow University. Here, I'm borrowing some technology that's normally used in cartoon animation, but I'm using it to see if hidden signals in the way that David moves identify him as a victim to attackers. And for comparison, he's brought three friends along for the same treatment. Six cameras record the positions of their joints as they walk, allowing the computer to combine the different views into a 3D model. The result is an animated video clip of each person's movement, showing no physical details at all. Next, I show the clips to professional bodyguards Lee and John. They are veterans of street fighting, so they should know how to spot a victim.
Lee, John, thanks for coming today. Now, in a moment, I'm going to show you a series of clips. Each clip will be a group of red dots. And what I want you to do is to study each clip very carefully and tell me what you see. Okay. Okay, can we have the first sequence, please?
Perception of vulnerability and aggression is a primitive survival instinct, but a profession for Lee and John.
I wouldn't say that this person was overly confident. There's nothing about the way that they walk that would, you know, give off any signs of you know, real strength of character.
At the same time, I mean, I wouldn't say that he goes completely the other way in terms of displaying very introvert or subservient body language. Also, I'd say that he's probably miles away, you know, yeah. He's just not engaged in where he is here and now.
I'm very interested in what you are both picking up here about the way in which you're saying he's not engaged with his environment. He's inward-looking. Shut off somewhat.
You can really see it when somebody is. They tend to walk, you know, brisk pace, confident gait, look around frequently. Everything about them says they're here and now.
Second clip, please. Thank you.
Any natural vulnerability in David or his friends and their movement alone will betray them.
OK, Lee first, perhaps. What are you seeing?
Okay, it's quite interesting because this is a complete contrast to what we've just seen. This person, if you're again looking at the spinal alignment from the side, is almost military straight. There's quite a swagger to it. There's almost a kind of feminine characteristic, i.e. the wiggle to the hips.
Yeah, absolutely. The way that he's over-exaggerating the movement of his arms, like you said already, tilting the head back, all of those things are going to attract attention to himself and possibly could result in confrontation of some sort, whether it was verbal or otherwise.
OK, clip three. OK, John, what do you see?
This guy's got serious problems. He's very subservient, introvert, very bad posture, he's bowed over. It's a very negative way to portray yourself.
Look at the very small movement of the hands, the very short steps, he's hunched forward. It's almost like, I don't want you to notice that I exist.
Yeah.
Very, very subservient, inward victim profile.
Well, this is a classic case of, if I close my eyes, maybe the rest of the world won't see me.
He's walking in denial.
And the last one, please. Lee,
nothing outwardly obvious here that would indicate vulnerability. Out of the four I've seen, this is the most likely you want to be.
This is a grey man, middle of the road, least likely to be a victim.
We've now studied the four clips. What I want you to do is select the one that you think is most vulnerable. If you like, imagine that you're an assailant on the street. Which one would you attack?
Without a shadow of a doubt, it's number three.
Absolutely. Number three is the one.
Reasons?
For one thing, just the subservient posture and his slow movement.
That's it. I agree completely. Everything about his character suggests that he's open to attack from somebody who's got predatory instincts and would recognise him as a victim.
OK, so it's number three. Mm. Well, look, I think it's about time we met these guys in the flesh, OK? OK, guys, come on in.
They've selected the third clip as the most vulnerable, but who was it in the clip? It was David.
So, I can reveal for you that, in fact, 18 months ago, David here was the victim of a very savage assault. Now, I understand that your business is, in fact, training people to avoid being victims of attack. Now, David here is by no means a very big guy, so I'm not expecting that you could change his physique. But what I want to find out is, after a session of training with you guys, can you affect the way he moves, his posture, the way he carries himself?
Most definitely. We can affect a positive change in his body language, the way he presents himself. Increase his awareness, make him a harder target.
Definitely.
Less likely to be selected as a victim of attack. I'm confident we could do that.
Fucking say anything!
Explosion goes from here to that.
First of all, stay switched on to your environment. Don't walk around in denial to everything that's going on around you.
Okay. If I bring my arms in a little bit more, good. You can look ahead of you always, you can head up. There's an improvement in what you're doing.
Lee and John's training techniques focus on awareness and physical confidence.
What we're doing is the vital targets on any man are always going to be the eyes and throat. So if this motion hasn't worked, my next motion is going to be to elbow him straight in the throat here. The most destructive weapons on your body are your head, your knees and your elbows. Grab it, put this shot in. Basically, these effects that you'll feel of adrenal stress need to be experienced and controlled. If he knows that I can turn him into a little grease spot on the pavement, he's not going to be interested in selecting me when there's other people to select. Best way to do that is to boom, hit him straight in the eyes, okay? As soon as I hit him in the eyes here, he's going to get this response, and boom, and then I hit him. I don't want to do this. I pull back or telegraph in any way. Boom, just simply here.
They claim just one session can make a difference. So after 4 hours of training, will David's movements still betray his vulnerability?
Use my head now. Well, let's do it to my head. Imagine, turn your hips. Go on. Just keep it
up.
Just natural.
Don't just think, you don't have to prepare for this, yeah? Just put your fingers in my eyes now. Just put them in my eyes, yeah?
Okay.
Push them in.
Control
push them in.
Right, now keep forgetting.
So pull the back of this hand and lift it with the head.
Right.
Good. Venom in the first shot, power in the second shot. Good. That's better, yeah?
David, an unusual afternoon for you, but how did you find that?
Yes, I've learned quite a good few good points. Walking a bit more straighter, looking at people in the eye, looking about, being more aware of what's actually happening around me, instead of looking so far down to the ground and looking not confident when I walk.
You've been a great sport, and before we finish up, I want you to do one more thing, which is to have your movement motion captured again to see if we can see a difference.
Yep.
Thanks again.
Thank you.
The final step in my experiment is to play the clips to a new audience, 10 boxers who really know how to handle themselves on the street. I'll play the clips in the same order, but this time number three is the new improved David. Will he still stick out as the victim?
Prince, you saw the four clips, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Which number was the weakest?
Number 4. Number 4. Number 3.
I think it's number 4.
4.
4.
Number 4.
Number 3.
3.
I think he's 4.
So just 3 of our 10 boxers picked David. So maybe what we've shown is that if you get into the right mindset, you can prevent yourself becoming victimised.